Don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. And make it on a triple dribble, you know, ride it in my fear. No slack, but luckily the seats go.
So, my money?
Come on, man. You know I don't have enough money to eat. Show me some love.
Some love? Like, what? You want a hug or something?
You know what I mean. I need some more time!
Okay, fine. Let me see. I can give you some more time, but I'm gonna have to raise the interest by 30%.
30%?!
And it's gonna have to be on time. You know I don't play when it comes to money. Speaking of things you don't play with, you got any food?
I don't really have much snacks, but... Here, I'll let you have some of these. They're my last box.
Only one box?
Bruh! These are all I have! I got these from the clearance section at Chandy Mart for 99% off!
Clearance? Oh, well, these are selling, right? Speaking of, I actually have a meeting with them later today.
So that means you have to leave to prepare, right?
Well, actually, I have tons of time to kill, so no rush, you know?
Oh.
So, what's new with you? It's been a while since we talked.
I don't really want to get into this, but recently my husband passed away and it was a very hard time for me. I even had to help cover funeral costs, and every single day I've just been grinding just to make my monthly payments. One of these days I might have to sell my kidneys to keep up.
You're quite the joker, aren't you? I didn't even know you had a husband. Let me check the time. Actually, it's almost time for my meeting with Chandy Industries, and to be honest, I'm still a little hungry. A growing boy needs to eat, you know? Anyways, sorry to say, but I kind of finished all your cookies.
What? No!
Well, anyways, thanks for the cookies. See ya. Oh, wait, don't forget about my money.
Oh, Lord. When will I ever be able to pay back this money? It's too much!
Ah, you made it! Here I was thinking you wouldn't show up.
Excuse me, what? We've been waiting for the past 30 minutes. Where were you?
Yeah. No, Biggie. I thought you guys would be 30 minutes late. Isn't that how brown people are? I had some very, very important, unexpected business to take care of. Anyways, we're all here, so let's just get started. Oh, Mr. Chatty, I think there was someone outside looking for you. They looked really worried. It seemed really important. I think you should go check it out.
Man, I'll be right back. Well, my representative here will fill you in on other details.
You won't suspect it. Yeah, fun doing business with you, buddy. You're pretty good.
Yeah, we
finished up.
Oh, I didn't see the guy you were talking about.
My bad. Well, I swear, they were out there. I don't know. But we finished up. So, time for me to skedaddle, okay? I'm gonna leave.
What losers! I think I just did the whole world a huge favor. Man, a business like that? What are they doing? They treat money like it grows on trees. Oh, man.
Aw, dang it, man. I just missed it. Well, how'd it go? Well, I just wanted to see the look on his face when he found out that we aren't signing this deal anymore. And said, I was looking all over the place for that person or the visitor that he saw. Well, turns out I didn't find any. Well, that man must be a little really crazy or something.
Yeah, about that, I decided to give him a chance and sign the deal.
You what?
Before you freak out, hear me out. He seems like a genuine guy, and he promised that we'll definitely benefit from this. In fact, he said that we would get 4 times more than we put in. So for $100K, it's actually worth it. You have nothing to worry about. We're gonna be rich.
Promised? He tricked us. This guy scammed so many people, and that is exactly why we're not gonna agree to this proposition. Oh my God, why would you believe his lies so easily? Now, because of you, our company has lost thousands and thousands of money. I told you exactly what to say in case I wasn't there. Oh my God, man, you're fired now.
So guys, really, what do you guys think? You really want to hang out with this Anaka Zaki guy? Like, I mean...
No, well, it's not even a question, man.
Okay, good. I thought you guys really wanted to meet up with this guy. I mean...
There's no way that's his hard-earned money. He definitely scammed some poor guy to get that money. Who knows, he probably would have made us pay for everything today, like that cheapskate he is.
Man... Yo, I don't really want to be friends with this guy, bro. He's been like scamming people and doing those kind of things. It was all good at first, but yo, I don't think it's good being around that guy anymore.
He just needs to be humbled a little bit. And he doesn't have any friends other than us. So, like, he doesn't have really any choice and he cannot do anything. So let's just have some fun without him. What do you guys think?
I'm down.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Lonely, I have nobody for my own.
Can I get you the kids menu?
Kids? Kids menu? Where do you see a kid here?
I'm so sorry. Okay, can I get you something to drink?
Yeah, you can get me some water, but make sure I have no ice.
Okay, I'll be right back. Again, I'm very sorry.
Kids?
Okay. I'm so sorry, sir. I need to.
You have
I'm
got
so
to be kidding me.
I'm so sorry.
I'm not hungry anymore.
Can I get
do you know who I am? I'm not gonna eat at a restaurant like yours anymore. I'm Zacchaeus, a well-respected, successful businessman.
I'm so sorry.
I'm not eating here anymore. Ugh. What a horrible day. I got all wet. And for what? My friends didn't even show up. Can't wait for tomorrow. Well, I might as well make use of the rest of the day and get some work done. But first, I gotta change out of these nasty clothes. Ugh.
Hey Zacchaeus, get down from the tree. I'm coming to your house today.
All of this garbage. What would be the easiest way to get rid of this? Might as well just throw the whole thing out. Oh man, I gotta clean all these pots. I don't wanna clean these pots, man. I'm so lazy. Maybe. Man, I'll just throw all of them out and buy new pots before Jesus comes. Let's go! Into the garbage you go! Job well done.
Hey Zach, buddy old pal! How you doing?
Good, I guess? Who are you?
It's your favorite cousin Gerald. Don't tell me you've already forgotten about me.
Who?
We met like a couple months ago at Sandeep's wedding. I thought you and me really hit it off, like formed a strong bond that day. Man, you are funny. Like, you're like a brother to me. Remember all the stories you shared about your company scammers are us? And all those bozos who just signed away millions? Haha, good ones.
Yes, I totally remember you now. 100%, buddy old pal. How could I forget my favorite cousin, Ronald? Gerald. Anyways, what do you want?
So, here's the situation. I got a teensy-weensy problem that you can solve it since you're that great Zach after all.
Great, I'm listening.
So, I just recently lost my job. These bosses just fired me for no reason. I was the best employee there. I don't even know what's going through their head. Anyway, I've been running on fumes for the past couple of months. I sold all my possessions just to live. But I still can't afford rent last month, so they just kicked me out. So I really need a place to stay just for a couple of months. And I remember you mentioned that you had a 4-bedroom mansion all to yourself. I was wondering if you can lend me a tiny room for a week until I find a place to go or a job. It doesn't have to be a room. Like, I can be sleeping on the couch, the floor, or the basement, or the storage room if you want me to. But I just don't have any luggage, so no mess whatsoever. I just need somewhere to go. And maybe some food and clothes.
You are so funny. Listen here, pal. I have a very, very important guest coming over. Very important. I can't have filthy peasants like you roaming all around in my house. What do you think this is? A homeless shelter? Man, this ain't no charity. You lost your job? You? Oh man, that sounds like a you problem. Bro, I'm gonna be 100 stars. I don't even know who the heck you are! Listen man, I really, really don't have time. Really don't have time. Man, you gotta go. You gotta go. I can't help you. Bro, you gotta go. I know! See you next fall! Daddy, daddy, doody, 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 daddy, doody, da. Oh, could that be Jesus?
Hello, Macha.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there, but yo, I kind of have to.
I have to go. Wait a minute. I just moved into this town from my country not too long ago. It will only take 5 minutes.
You better make it quick then.
You see, I have this really big mattress that needs to be moved. You see, the moving company, they did not do a good job, and I'm really weak. I need a big, strong boy to come and move it for me.
Listen, you tiny old man, I don't have time for any of your shenanigans. I have a very, very important guest coming over to my house. And I still haven't finished cleaning. Look, I came out with this, and you interrupted me in the middle of this? 5 minutes? 5 minutes? Bro, it's gonna take 30 minutes to move your bed. You did that! Man, look at my casserole! My casserole's on fire, man! Yo, you distracted me so much I couldn't take care of my house and my house is about to burn down! You never come back to my house again!
Hello, Macha. Nikandu Visheshim.
Rada, Ninki, Trinda, Iranda, and never you don't know what I'm, huh? Ninda, and the way you got off.
You, Rada,
I'm sorry. I had some things to take care of, and I didn't want a toxic atmosphere. I just wanted to hang out with my homies.
Toxic, huh? Toxic, huh? You never want to need money, love it, you know?
I know. Just leave me. I agree with you. Just leave me.
Anyways, I'm going to be throwing a house party on the weekend, and you're going to be my VIP guest. What do you say about that?
I'm not coming to your lame party. Not ever, Jim. I'm never coming to your house. You ditched me. And I'll never forget that. And what are you gonna matter with it? Never, you hear me? You're a loser. I don't even know you, Jim. I don't even know if that is your real name. You know what? Never like you. Never. Now, I have a new friend. A new friend coming to my house. Jesus. He's coming to my house today. So get out! Go! Get out of my house! Go!
What on earth is happening? Man, there were so many people causing a disturbance at my door. And my door? People don't come here. What's going on? And Jesus, this Jesus guy, where is he? Oh boy, it's been such a long day. Is Jesus even gonna come here? Where's he been? Like, I had to go through all the trouble of cleaning my house and making food twice. Who does he think he is? And I have to shoo all these pests away. Who do these people think they are showing up to my place? Oh, people should be treating me like a king. I'm Zacchaeus. People should be cooking for me. Who does he think he is? I thought my door was locked. Well, whatever. Anyways. Man. Not gonna lie, you kinda took a really long time to get here. But, it's okay, whatever. How you doing?
I am not slow in keeping my promises, as some understand slowness. I am patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish. It is good to wait for the salvation of the Lord.
Okay. So, what brings you here today?
Zach, I want to be your friend and offer you the gift of salvation.
Oh, that's great! Actually, I really want to be friends with you. I want to be just like you. You know, you got all these people lined up watching you. I want to be super popular. But, a gift? I don't see no gift, so what's this salvation thing?
Zach, if you want to be loved by others, first you have to love others and love your neighbor as yourself. You have to be kind to everyone and turn away from your crookedness and sin.
Man, but I don't want to do that. I want to live the good life. I want it to be all about me, Zach. I'm the star of the show.
The day of the Lord will come like a thief. The heavens will disappear. The elements will be destroyed by fire. And the earth and everything in it will be laid bare. Since everything will be destroyed in this way, what kind of people ought you to be? You ought to live holy and godly lives. Your positions and status mean nothing, Zach. You can't take them to heaven. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven.
So, like, everything will be destroyed? Everything? Like, all the money and, like, wealth and the things that I've built up to now will mean nothing? So, this heaven place must be nice, huh? How do I get there? Like, what must I do? You got a map?
Oh, my child, the first step is you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your mind. For it is by grace that you have been saved, through faith. This is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, and not by works, so that no one can boast. You must love your neighbors and show kindness to those around you.
Love my neighbors. See, I can love you, man. But my friends, my neighbors? I don't know. Like, they're all so mean. And I have to help them. How do I help them? Like, should I even help them? They don't deserve it.
They don't love me.
What? If you love me, keep my commands. Zach, you need to love them. Let me tell you something. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, he will sit on his throne, and he will separate all the people as a shepherd separates the sheep and the goats. He will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you?" The king will reply, "Truly, I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me." Then he will look to those on his left. "Depart from me, you who are cursed, for I was in need and you did not look after me." He will reply, "Truly, I tell you, whatever you did not do for one of the least of these, you did not do for me." They will go away to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. Zach, I came to your house 3 times today and you turned me away. You didn't help me when I was weak. You didn't give me a place to stay. And you didn't forgive and show compassion as I have forgiven you. You've also been greedy and cheating people out of money. You need to show love and compassion to others.
Jesus, I'm so sorry. Starting today, I'm gonna repay everyone I did wrong for.